Good morning, children. I'm Ramya, your science teacher of Kakatiya Public School. Today again, I'm back with another new topic, communicable diseases. Microbes. So what are microbes? The organisms which we cannot see with our eyes, but we can observe only under the powerful microscope, are nothing but the microbes, and they are also living organisms, but we cannot see with our eyes. But and what are they? They are like bacteria, virus, fungi, protozoa, etc. Okay, these are some kind of microbes which we can observe under the microscope. And are they doing favor to us? No. In some bacteria they will be helping in us, but remaining all these microbes, they are just disturbing our life. Nowadays we are very much, why we are in lockdown position? Because of this virus, one of the virus, coronavirus. It is also microorganism. We cannot see, but we can observe only under the powerful microscope. As their size is very, 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 very small, we cannot see with our eyes. So today in our class, we are going to discuss about the diseases which we are spreading by these microbes. Like if you are seeing, our topic name is communicable diseases. That means diseases which are causing these microorganisms, they are very much harmful to us. They are doing harmful to us, but how they are spreading diseases? In what ways, in what mode they are spreading diseases to us? That we are going to discuss now. Okay? Okay, here are the microbes like bacteria, viruses and protozoa. So, what kind of diseases they are spreading? And like if you take the bacteria, the diseases like tuberculosis, cholera, pneumonia, typhoid, meningitis, plague. These are the diseases spread by the bacteria. Tuberculosis, if you coming to the tuberculosis, it is like a continuous coughing. It is a continuous coughing. If the symptoms of this disease is nothing but the continuous coughing. The person who suffers with this is really continuously coughing. And cholera is also like causing some like respiratory problems. And pneumonia is affecting the lungs, bronchitis, typhoid. You very well, you know, all these people suffering with the typhoid. It is like a fever, headache, etc. Meningitis, they are spreading on the, affecting the spinal cord. And plague, it is one kind of the bacterial infection. Next, coming to the viruses, they are what diseases they are spreading. Like common cold, chickenpox, rabies, polio, measles. Common cold, always the people suffering with the cough and cold. Chickenpox, normal cold, what we are getting, that is from the viruses. Chickenpox, you know, that small air like bubbles are coming on the total body. That is also because of virus. Rabies is nothing but with the dog bite, what we get the disease rabies. And polio, there is a attacking of paralysis, our limbs will be fallen off and we cannot, there is no energy, no life in the limbs. And measles also, like coughing and sneezing. Next, coming to the protozoa, another microbe which is causing the diseases like malaria and the dysentery. Malaria is nothing but the fever. It is a fever. What are the symptoms of a person who is suffering with malaria? They will be getting the shivering, cold, fever with the shivering. And dysentery is nothing but the respiratory problems also. Okay, this is about the microbes and diseases spreading by the different types of microbes. And now that these diseases, these kind of diseases are spread through different ways. These are spreading in a different ways, and some are contagious and some are non-contagious. Some are non-contagious. Contagious is nothing but the diseases which spread through direct contact, person to person contact. If it is there, that kind of spreading diseases is nothing but the contagious, and non-contagious is nothing but through another mode of transmission. Like that is the lesson about communicable diseases. Communicable diseases is nothing but the from the surroundings how we are getting the diseases. That is nothing but the communicable diseases. So these all are the diseases spreading by different microorganisms can be spread through different ways, like through air, through water and food, through direct contact, through insect bites. So how, which kind of diseases are spreading in which kind of mode, we are going to discuss now. Okay, so the diseases I have wrote in now on board, like diseases about different types of microorganisms spreading different types of diseases. So they are of two types, like contagious or non-contagious. As I said, contagious is nothing but the person to person contact. If it is there, if a disease spread through person to person contact, is nothing but the contagious diseases, and through other mode we call it as a non-contagious. So here are the different types of modes through which diseases can be spread. First one is through air. So that, like microbial infections can be spread through air. So how it will be spreading through the air, and what kind of diseases we are getting through the air, we will be seeing now. So air. So one of the dangerous mode of transmission of diseases, number of diseases. Like if you take air, so some people, like infected persons, those who are infected persons already suffering with the diseases, if they sneezes or coughs or just they spit anything on the roadside or whatever it may be, whatever the microbes are present in that, diseases causing microorganisms are present in that droplets of the sneezing and the coughing, that will be transmitted, opened into the air and transmitted through the air to the healthy person. In this way, diseases can be spread through air. So that means what we have to do, like we have to, while coughing, unknowingly if we are suffering with a person, infected person suffering with a cough, they will be coughing outside, sneezing outside and spitting anything outside. So what happens from their droplets, whatever the microorganisms are present, are mixing in the air, and that will be transmitted to the healthy person. So what kind of diseases we will get through the air? So whooping cough is nothing but the lungs, it affects the lungs, and the person suffering with this disease keep on coughing. And diphtheria is also related to that only. And influenza, you know very well, a common cold, and flu, like swine flu, those are also from the through the air. And measles also, sneezing and coughing. Chicken pox is also spread through the air. And common cold, whatever the cold we are getting, that is also from the through air only. So what we have to take, what remedies we have to take, what remedies we have to take to stop these diseases, to stop these diseases, what remedies we have to take. So the person who is suffering with such kind of diseases should use a handkerchief while sneezing or coughing, and should not spit on the open areas. Use dustbins or wash basins for the spitting, and better not to come outside till the person cures his disease. And the person who are healthy should always cover their nose and the mouth while going outside, and should wash our hands properly if we are coming from outside. Okay, so if we follow these kind of remedies, we cannot get the diseases through air. This is about the diseases spreading through air. Next, coming to the through food and water. So not only from the air, whatever the food we are taking and water which we are drinking can also spread the diseases. So how we will be getting the diseases through this water and food? So how we are getting? So uncovered food. So whatever the food which we are eating, that should be covered always. After preparing the food at home, after cooking, your mother is putting in the utensils and covering with the lid. So we have to be careful in covering the food items with the lid or wrapping with the covers or whatever. We have to just cover the food. And water also, we have to, if the water is not a good like not hygienic, filtered water also, we are going somewhere other places. So there we may not get the pure water, drinking water. So at that time we will be taking some other water, and through that water also we may get the infection. So especially from the uncovered food and with the dirty water and some roadsides you will be seeing. So what kind of remedies we have to take for avoiding this kind of diseases? That means the food should be always covered. Whatever the food we are taking, wherever also it may be, the food should be covered, and the water which we are drinking should be of pure and filtered water. Then only we can avoid this kind of diseases. And we should be very careful if we are eating outside food. So the place should be very hygienic. At home also we should cover the food with the lid, and outside the hygienic conditions and the hygienic places only we have to take the food. This is about the through food and water. This is a spreading through food and water. Next, coming to the through direct contact. As I said, if the infection is spreading from one person to another person, if the person is in contact with the other person, such kind of we call it as a contagious diseases. That means infected person, if is moving closely with another person, healthy person, the diseases will be spreading easily. And what kind of diseases, how the diseases are spreading through that infected person if he will be coming in contact with other person. That means whatever the belongings which he is using, the infected person is using, like comb, his utensils and a towel, etc. The some things which he is using, that things may carry the diseases from the infected person. And the person who is healthy person is sharing these kind of belongings of the infected person will spread the disease easily. So what kind of diseases we are getting through direct contact? Scabies, especially the skin diseases. Skin diseases will be spreading easily through the direct contact. Scabies is nothing but the itching on the skin, and leprosy is the there will be the folding of the fingers. There will be the infection, the fingers will be eaten away. And ringworm, so it will be forming like infections in a ring form. So that is why name called as a ringworm. If not only to the other person, if we are getting such kind of disease, if I am itching, suppose on my wrist it is a infection and I am just itching the ear, and on my body somewhere if I itch it again, I will be getting on other parts of my body also. So we have to be very careful with these diseases. And so how we have to take remedies, what kind of remedies we can take so to avoid this kind of diseases and spreading. Whatever the belongings are there of infected person should be cleaned properly with the disinfectants, and the room also should be disinfected, and the person suffering with this disease should be placed in another room, and it should be disinfected. The toilets which are using should also be disinfected. If we follow this some rules, we can avoid this kind of diseases. Next, coming to the through insect bites. Another topic, another spray mode of spreading is through insect bites. So many insects will be there, like flies, mosquitoes, etc. They will be spreading the diseases. How they are spreading? They will be the infected person, they are biting the infected person and coming and biting to the another healthy person, can also spread those diseases. So what kind of diseases can be seen with this? Malaria, yellow fever, dengue fever. Malaria, you know, it will be coming in the certain day times or a night times. In a period of time it will be getting shivering, fever, chillness, etc. Dengue fever is a low in the platelet count. The platelet will be pollen, and yellow fever is also kind of a malaria fever only. So these kind of diseases are spread through the insect bites. And how they are spreading? They are spreading through the stagnant water. In our surroundings, if there is water is stagnant, and the mosquitoes, and they will be breeding on that water, and they will be putting more eggs, and they will be developing more insects, and that will be infecting to us. And also by eating the different kinds of outside food and uncovered food also we are getting. So how we have to overcome this problem? What remedies we have to take? We have to clean our surroundings with the sprays, mosquito sprays or whatever the sprays will be there, that should be sprayed in our surroundings. Our bathrooms and everything should be kept clean. Kitchen also should be cleaned thoroughly, weekly 2 to 3 times we should clean our kitchen, and our surroundings also should be careful. If it is in a rainy season, the water will be stagnant in some places, so at that time we have to take care by spraying the mosquito sprays. Okay, this is about the communicable diseases. Now we are going to see about the vaccines. Next one is vaccines. What are vaccines? Vaccines are nothing but the substances which will resist our body from the diseases. So for example, have you heard about this word many times? If we go to hospitals, like small babies, so doctor will be suggesting for giving the vaccines. That means these are the substances which make the body for resisting many diseases. Okay, substances that make body resistant from diseases. Okay, substances which makes the body from this resistant from this. That means if we are taking this vaccine, if we are suffering, if we are infected with any kind of disease, so that will be automatically cured. That means it will be not affecting more to our bodies. That we call it as a vaccine. So these are generally given to the newborn babies from time periods, time intervals. They will be like starting from the birth to like 3rd month, 4th month, 5th month, 9th month, 18 months, 1 year, 15 months, like this. They will be keep on giving some kind of vaccines to avoid the different types of diseases. So with the help of this my vaccines, we can avoid some diseases. So now in this period, the corona is one of the pandemic disease which are spreading all over the world and disturbing many lives. So we don't have the proper vaccine for this. So it may take some years to invent the vaccine to avoid that corona disease. Still that, we have to stay home, stay safe. We have to follow some precautions to avoid the disease. So if once the person is falling sick, what kind of remedies we have to take? So if the person is suffering with any cold or cough, immediately rush to the hospital and just take a treatment, and always take a drinking water which is boiled and filtered. And if you are getting any diseases or anything, immediately we have to go to the doctor for the proper treatment. This is all about the communicable diseases and how they are spreading. And vaccines, in a proper interval of times, if a person is getting the vaccines, we can avoid the number of diseases. Now I'll be giving the worksheet, so follow the worksheet. Okay, here is the worksheet. So how are communicable diseases spread? So how they will be spreading? So what is communicable disease? Well, first of all, write what is a communicable disease, and next is what is vaccine, how is it useful. So write about the definition of the vaccine, that is a substance which makes the body to resist some diseases, is nothing but the vaccine. Write the modes of spreading diseases through microbes, like means through air and water, through air, through food and water, through direct contact, through insect bites. So this is all about the worksheet. I hope you all understood the topic very clearly, and soon I will be coming with the revision video. In that video I will be giving about the vaccines, different types of vaccines, and when should be given to the small babies, at what age it should be given, that I will be saying in that. Based on that video only you will be having the exam. So be ready for that. Till that time, solve the worksheet. All the best.